begin today's ceremony, I would like everyone to stand for the presentation and posting of colors by the Boynton Beach Fire Rescue Department's honor guard, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance in prayer by Commissioner Woodrow Day.
May be seated. On this rainy morning, let us have a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we come here this morning to dedicate this new fire station. We are thankful to you, Lord, for your great blessing in providing this community this new station. We come here this morning to dedicate all the contents of this building to the glory of God and to the emergency needs of the people of Boynton Beach. We are pleased to have this new facility and especially the men and women who are part of this great kingdom. We are humbled that you have brought us together here today in the midst of all that's going on. COVID-19, rioting, looting, killing. Yet you, Father, still allow your light to shine in dark times and upon this great city. And we are most grateful. This new fire station facility will be the home of many years to come to our firefighters on a 24-hour shift basis to work, eat, sleep, watch TV, study, train, and relax. It will house the apparatus, all the tools of firefighters and the medical emergency responses. A place from which firefighters can respond to calls for help from our citizens. A place where firefighters can hone their skills and train to do better the job they have been called to do. Help us, O Lord, to use this facility, the implements of their trade and the skills and knowledge you have allowed our firefighters to acquire in a way that will bring glory to your holy. city pleased to be a part of Boynton Beach welcome. Walk with our firefighters through the fire, Lord. Protect every man and woman of this department as they give their wholehearted devotion to the job to which they have been called. We ask it all in the holy and matchless name. Let every heart say, Amen.
Thank you, Mr. May, for those kind words. And thank you for all your support over the years for public safety. At this time, I would like to invite Lori Bavaria, City Manager, to the podium to introduce the city's elected officials and town square partners.
First priority for public safety, and if you look at some of the developments that have taken place over the past few years with our police department, with our fire, our EMS. There's no doubt that the safety and security of our residents is our first priority. So I'm proud to have been a part of the decisions that were made to have this station built, to have the police station built across town. I'm proud of the increase in staffing that's taken place in our fire department. It's just, again, it's a testament to the fact that the government is working with the people. The government doesn't care about the people, and their safety is our first priority. So thank you very much, and very thankful.
Newly elected, but not new, Commissioner Hay.
Thank you, Laura. I've been around for a couple of mingles in the new range. But I'm glad to see us in a new chapter two of this station and many projects that we have on the books for the city of Boynton Beach. But I recall chapter one when they tried to close this station. I was on the dais and I was strictly against closing this station because it serves a section of the city that sometimes get overlooked. But I'm happy to see this station has been renovated. The station is just beautiful. And there are a lot of great things, a lot of men and women that work in this station that will contribute tremendously to our community. So I'm happy and excited in the direction that I've seen the city going, and it stops off with firefighters of Boynton Beach. So proud and honored. Keep doing the job that you're doing. We'll end this together.
Thank you. And we also have a special guest with us today, our former city commissioner who sat on the dais in making the decisions to move this project forward, Joe Casello, who's now the state representative. And I'd like to ask him to come up and say a few words.
Thank you, city manager. It's great to be here. I think I was the only firefighter that served at the dais here at Boynton Beach. And so as a former firefighter, I really saved a lot. And as we like to say, the fire service is no fire is in the rain. That being said, coming from the Northeast, spent over 3 years in fire service, we spent many a year in fire stations. And a lot of our stations up north were built in the 1800s, early 1900s. And they were made for buses and wagons. And to see something like this come out of the ground, and how we've come so far in fire service, is just great. I just want to say, though, and it's been alluded to here, that this is brick and mortar, brick and block steel. That's not what makes the fire station. What makes the fire station is the men and women who serve in this. It's been alluded to that they will watch TV, they'll speak, they'll eat together. They will become family here. They will become a second family. And that will emulate out there to the public when they do their jobs. That's what makes the fire service so special and so great. So God bless all the men and women who serve in this station. And God speak. Thank you.
Contractor who built this building, this beautiful facility.
Thank you, Lori. Joe, 3 years ago, opposed, in favor of this, that great wrestling commission. Thank you for your trust and belief. Holly Roth, he never gets enough credit, stands in the background. He's been a champion along with Anderson. My left, who oversaw the design and construction with us. I will ask Chuck Taylor to come up and raise you high in just a second. They were the design build contractor of this facility. We went through a lot of transitions, not to mention COVID-19. And what that did to us as a development contractor, saying we still have to get this facility built on time. I give all the credit to the construction group for putting in place the safety. Kathy, who has been with us since the original chief who was on this project, came and left, but was great to work with. She was just telling me there's a few things I would do different. I said, well, please educate us because we want to learn from our lessons. But thank you all at the city. You've been great partners. We went to love to speak, but she's been at every meeting. And we learned a lot from her. Mike has been to a lot of those meetings with her. And we thank you for the opportunity. And I'll ask Chuck to love to speak for NCI. Thank you again.
City of Boynton Beach for allowing HB High the opportunity to serve in this community. A lot of times we look at construction work as that, as building buildings. This is a community service project that's going to add to Boynton Beach now and in the future. When we talk about partnerships, if you've been involved with the construction in and off, we talk about safety and the group that administers that safety is OSHA. Before we started these projects, we called OSHA and said, hey, would y'all come out and be a part of this project in advance? Most contractors would shy away from that. But we called them in, we said, we're going to run a safe project. We want you to be a part of that from day one. And they did, and it's been a very successful partnership. Again, with the support that we've got from the city, the building department, Anderson, Deborah, and Shane, just anything that came up, and it's always managed. Everybody had a candid attitude from a bit in the field to the administration of the office. So, HA High, again, just appreciates the opportunity for this community service.
Thank you for building us a phenomenal station. Beautiful. And after finish here with the ceremony, you get an opportunity to tour it. It's just beautiful. Lastly, could not have done this without our team of staff members that have worked on this project literally for years now. And it isn't one person that gets anything done. It's a group that brings creativity, work ethic, and everything you need to pull this together. And I'd like to ask all of you to come up and stay and walk the mask on. So I'm going to ask Colin, as much as he loves when I do that. I'm not going to ask you to speak. I just want you all to come up to be recognized. Colin, Debbie Coles, Anderson. Is Andrew here? I don't see him. Ann Mack, Public Works Director. Mara, our Director of Finance. Come on up. Just stand there for 2 seconds, okay? Chief Petty. It's beautiful, it's modern, our new station, new technologies. As I say, you'll get to walk through and see the building. And we've designed it to house and prepare us for future growth in our downtown. This project isn't going to be the only thing happening. We look forward to additional residents moving into our city and businesses, and that will all obviously require some fire and rescue services that go with that to support that. So we are prepared and ready and have room to grow here, and we're ready. So with that, Chief Petty, we have an uncoupling ceremony, which is a tradition, fire tradition, Mayor. Come on up. I'd like to ask the commission and Joe, all up to stand up beside the mayor, and Chief Petty will hold the public and rescue and stand behind the photos.
I
all going to take your seats. At this time, I would like to ask Lieutenant Carpenter of the Army Guard to come up. He will explain the tradition of ringing of a bell.
Thank you, good morning. As we know, the fire service is a very rich tradition. Prior to modern technology with radios and toners, firefighters were called to service by the ringing of the bell. Different volleys meant different things, different calls to action. The ringing of the volley of 444 represented a new ship as the station was open and as firefighters were ready to serve the public. In a fitting manner, Lieutenant Craig Kodak, who will be a station officer here at Station 1, will be giving us the volley of 444. The fire station 1 is open and ready to serve the citizens of Boynton Beach.
Again, thank you all for coming. This concludes the event, and the station is open for tours.